Hello everyone. Today we will learn about the boundary extractor, the type to perform correlation in Jmeter. So open the application.
Why?
Jmeter. After that, I'll string open browser. And let me open the template for recording template. Recording. Okay. After that, I need to pass this port mapping into the browser so that I can use it. So I'm just opening the Internet Explorer browser. So that we can change the LAN setting, localhost 8888. Okay, perfect. And now I'll start the recording from here by clicking the start button, and once it will start, I'll open the application and go through the flow. Now we got this window, we'll just click on OK on this window, and it is showing that recording is started. Okay, but yeah, this is a junk request, so I am deleting it for now, and I am going to start. So I'm typing the URL newtools.demoaut.com. So this is the URL. Okay, this is the launch request. Okay, let me do one thing. Let me remove this request as well, or disable it for now, let's say. And I will copy this URL and reopen the browser, so that will open the URL directly, and junk request will get be deleted. Now here we can see it is my launch request, so I am just renaming it to launch. After that, I'm just entering the username and password and click on sign in button. It will allow me to sign into the application. Okay. And this is a sign in request, so I'm just sign in, changing its name so that it will help me while I need to perform multiple action on the flow. I'm not making any change in this particular screen, so I'm just clicking on the continue button. I'm giving it a name as a continue for now. Continue, and the same thing in this screen as well. Continue, and give it a name of continue. Continue one. Okay. So now I just need to click on the, by entering the mandatory field, I'm just now clicking on the secure purchase button, and itinerary has been booked. Okay, so booked. Now I am stopping this recording so that we can see what has happened. Okay, this is the junk request. Again, this is, if you see, like it is a server name was api.ping.com, and same in this particular request. So I am deleting these two requests. Okay, this is my URL which I hit. And after that, this is the sign in request. After that, these are the requests. When I click on the first continue, round trip, trip type is round trip, from port, from month, from day, to port, to month, to day, all the things are there. Let's say for now I am planning to correlate this value round trip. So what will I do? Okay, let me check where I can get this value. Let me go to view result tree, click on the request number, let's say 70. Check in it's a response data, it's not 71. Okay, round trip. Yes, it is there. Trip type as round trip. It's checked. It is showing that it was checked. Okay, so I need to perform a correlation function under this request, request number 70. And when we go to post processor, we have multiple options with the help of which we can perform post processor. We have already covered the regular expression extractor and XPath extractor. So now in this session we will learn about the boundary extractor. This is similar to what we use in loadrunner, where we like say param, we need to pass the left and right boundary. So I'm just clicking over here. So first of all we need to give some name to it. Let's say okay, trip type, this is the name for it. Okay, now I need to give its left boundary. So let's see what is the left boundary for round trip. Left boundary starting from the double quote to, let's say, input type. This is the complete left boundary for this. So let me pass it over here. And what is the right boundary for this? Right boundary, I am taking only this double quotes for now. And let's see what will happen. Double quotes, okay. Match number for now, I am considering it the very first match number, because if I will copy it from here and search it in the response of this particular request, this is the first instance or first ordinance for this. And what in case we did not get this value, we will mark it as a default value, as a value of trip type not found. In case this correlation function fail, we'll get this message at that place. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to pass this variable name into this round trip, dollar curly brackets, then c underscore round trip. So I'm assuming this should work now. Let's see whether we have performed correlation function properly or not. So I'm going to select view result tree and let me click on the start button. It is asking me if I want to save it before starting to execute it, but I said no. These are some unnecessary or junk requests. So after going through the complete flow, we can delete them. So okay, it is showing that execution is complete. So let's see what we will get in this request, 83 request. What is the value? It's showing round trip. Perfect. What we have passed in our script, trip type. Trip type is C underscore trip type. So that means the correlation function works well. Let's say if I change this value 1 to 2, what will happen in that case? Let's see. Okay, I'm marking the scroll automatically. So what it will do is, it will automatically scroll down to the corresponding request when this small box is full with the requests. So let's see what happened to this. It's one way, perfect. So this means that we have performed the our correlation function correctly. So this is the way I have explained, we can use boundary extractor as a correlation method or post processor method in Jmeter. So there are multiple other ways as well we can perform these actions. So we will learn them in a different videos. In next videos we'll learn them. So let me tell you some basic things about the boundary extractor. parameter specifically. So what all things are there? This is the name of boundary extractor. After that, apply to main samples or subsamples. Only main sample we want to work. Sometimes there is some child sample is also there. So on which sample we want to apply this method? Whether only main sample or main sample and subsample, or only in the subsamples, or sometimes we need to use Jmeter variable for this. So we can use it as well. Okay, after that, fields to check, where we need to check for these values, whether it is in the body only, then body unescaped body, body as a document, or in the response header we want to check it for these boundaries, or request headers we want to check, or in the URL, response code, or response message. So these are the multiple options Jmeter gave us to check for this boundary in the field to check. Okay, so this is all for today's session. In case you have any doubt, any concern, just comment out in the video and I'll respond on that. Thank you.